Well, Ethan, we finally made it. The Big Apple.
It's the Big Easy, you idiot. The Big Easy.
The Big Easy. What? What's a Big Easy?
Whatever. We're here, we're exhausted, and we gotta find a place to stay.
Did you get an Airbnb?
No, man. The city is gonna show me the way.
What does that even mean?
Shh. The city will show us the way.
Okay.
See? That guy. That guy is a New Orleans.
I don't think that's what you call him.
Whatever he's called. That guy knows the best place to stay in all of New Orleans. Excuse me, sir. Excuse me.
Oh, maybe he's a Buckingham Palace guard. They can't.
Special, we're not in the UK or in Britain or South America. Like, we're in New Orleans.
Hey, man, we just got into town. Do you know of a place we might be able to stay?
Yeah, is there anywhere nearby that maybe we could crash?
Not really, but sometimes I guess he just gets excited about the world is. Anyways, why are you guys here?
The food.
No, we're not here for the food. Why are we actually here?
I play guitar.
But why New Orleans?
I mean, there's so much history here, like Jelly Roll Morton, Harry Connick Jr., like all I've ever read about it, and how there's music everywhere. Why wouldn't a musician want to be here?
And I'm an actor, so when I heard that this guy's headed down here, I looked up and saw there's a bunch of auditions, so I thought, why not?
Well, you came to the right place. This hotel is in the middle of everything. Actually, I'm just about to go to a great club that's got a really good local band playing. If you guys want to go.
Totally, yeah.
Good food, too.
Let's go.
What love? Shawnee Michaels on the drums. Yeah, that's right. We continue on now with a little ditty called Hit the Ground Running, featuring our fantastic jazz dancers. Why don't you put a big round of applause? You're going to hear from Dan Gillen, you're going to hear from El Waddell, and you're going to hear from Joe Kitts. Thank you.
I've never eaten so much in my life.
Glad you guys enjoyed it. That one's actually one of my favorites. Oh, hey, the hotel's right around the corner. I should probably get back to lock up. What are you guys gonna do for the rest of the night?
I think we might walk around the neighborhood a little bit, kind of see the sights. Thank you so much for all your help. It's been great.
No problem. See you guys around.
See ya.
Yeah.
What's up, you guys? You new in town?
Isn't that obvious?
Well, we, like, just got in. Like, just got in today.
We dropped our bags off and hit the city.
And that's the way to do it. There's too much to do here to even waste a second.
Well, what brought you fellas to New Orleans?
I was born here.
The food.
We should get along nicely.
I know this great place a few blocks down if you guys want to go get something.
I could eat.
Actually, I think we should get back to the hotel. It's getting pretty late. Why don't we catch up with you guys tomorrow? We're just staying right around the block.
All right. See you guys tomorrow.
Awesome.
Hey, we should get out of here, too. Some weird stuff starts to happen late at night.
Thank you.
So, how's the life of two starving artists?
Pretty good, actually. I've got an audition lined up for later today.
Yeah, I'm gonna start looking for work, too.
Well, so I might know some people. You play guitar, right?
Yeah.
So it turns out, my friend's band is actually looking for a new guitar player. And their rehearsal starts, in like 5 minutes. You should go down there and tell
them
I thank
you. That's so kind of you. Thank you.
No problem.
Oh, hey guys, I'm gonna head to my audition. I'll be right back.
All right, break a leg.
Thank you.
Dashiell, why are you still here? My friend Dan is waiting for you.
Hey, have you seen two funny-looking guys Three Stooges looking?
Believe me, I know exactly who you're talking about.
That Three Stooges, that's funny.
I'm not sure what just happened. I'll go.
Oh, the places I would like to show you, although I hardly know you, I have a funny feeling we'd make a perfect pair. The sights I want to see you seeing, the nights of you and me. Just one A. Every night it ain't a different date. Call each one of them the same pet name. Hey, baby. In a row I have my ducks. Loads of gals give me loads of yucks. Leave the cooing to the other clucks. Wing clip savvy. Got a good white whiny with love. Always practice what I preach. Keep temptation at an easy reach. Stick to dolls who wash their hair and bleach. I'm happy. Choose. Never gonna sing the tie-down blues. Other guys would kill to fill my shoes. I don't mean maybe. Got a good. What do I need with love? That was a near miss. Talk about a close shave. Flirted with disaster. There must be someone up there watching over me. Talk about a poorly glory. Peter Rabbit's missing footsie. It means I roll about a tootsie. Got a good. What do I need with
I'm sorry I'm late. I'm here for the audition.
What? Who are you?
My name's Dashiel. I'm
Dashiel? You want to spell that for me?
D-A-S.
Forget it. What do you think? What? I'm sorry.
My friend Megan told me about an audition.
Megan who?
Megan Swindle.
Megan doesn't remember. I don't know.
I'm sorry I'm late. I got hungry. I got lost.
Okay, so you want to be in this band?
Yeah.
Oh, hey, folks, you want him in the band?
No.
Well, there's your audition. Dashiel, is that name?
Yeah.
So, look, you know, this is New Orleans, man. We could call Trumbull Short, we could call Dr. John. I mean, yeah, I'm sorry. I mean, go ahead.
Are you sure?
You know, I just need to tell you.
No! Get out!
Some people, you know. Anyways. Pretty good. You know, our gig the other day at the Crescent City Club was pretty good. Let's talk a little bit about that. Joe, that was a great solo, man. Great break. Joe Kitts on alto saxophone. Oh, man. Hey, Brandon Reidenberg, I'm really sorry. I told everybody at Crescent City that you guys were, that Dan was soloing, actually, it was your solo. So they docked me $100, and I apologize. So that was a nice solo on Prince, and that was an even better solo on Hit the Ground, man. Kill him. That was fantastic. Dan and Prince, the only way you can make that better is to play it on guitar. Maybe tomorrow night with special guest John DeVersa, maybe we'll have a battle with Evie and guitar. I don't know. Anyways, great job. That was a fantastic solo. Thank you, Dan, for that. Charlotte, wonderful melody with Mr. Kitts. That was great. You guys sounded fantastic. Charlotte Packer on the flugelhorn with Joseph Kitts. That was fantastic, man. And Eli, you are, where did you go? Oh, there he is. You still remain your freshman status. So we love you, and you're a great player, but you're still nicknamed the freshman. But nice solo, Eli. Way to go, Eli. All right, so we got to practice for Mardi Gras. So let's take out that Duke tune second line, and let's get the clarinet players, Emma and Nathan, out front. And we're gonna hear from Sam Dunlap a little bit later on trumpet, and Eli and Sierra, we're gonna play some trombone, right? All right, let's rehearse. Let's nail this, all right? Go right ahead.
Any luck?
Nothing. Nothing at all.
Me neither, man. They just turned me away at the door. It's disrespectful.
That's rude.
Yeah, I mean, it might have been because I was 20, 30 minutes late, but still, it's rude. Just
so, I know the best places to make this night one to remember. You might want to go ahead and get dressed. It's already kind of late.
I beg your pardon?
Well, is that what you're wearing to Mardi Gras? Mardi Gras? Only the most exciting party of the entire year?
I don't know if I can do a party right now, man. I just kind of want a steak and a nap. Is that too much to ask?
Well, considering the amount of money we have, yes, it's too much to ask, Dashiell.
All right, enough! It doesn't matter how much money you have. Who rejected you? The city is alive, and there is no time to waste!
I don't need a new career, sympathetic guy.
We're going to continue on with Get Up and Go. It's a Sammy Nestico arrangement. It's going to feature Jason Hoops on piano, Max Holzelbeck on the drums, and Rose Kitts on the tenor saxophone.
Thank you.
So besides some of our other guests that you've seen already this evening, and we'll see again, and I'll talk about them later, we have the most important guest of the evening, or guests, I should say, the King Philip Middle School Jazz Band. Let's give them a big round of applause. Such a great group of wonderful, young, talented students. We do an improv class for both Bristow and KP on Tuesday nights. It's taught by Larry Garreau, who's one of our adjunct jazz staff, if you could call that. And I happen to go down there quite a bit and check out the class, and the kids are wonderful. We've done a couple of concerts. They're such wonderful players, and it's just a refreshing gift to see such fantastic music making at such a young age. So let's give them a big round of applause. And the outstanding work of Mr. Joseph Gamgee, their director, which we're going to give them applause. That's right. Mr. Gamgee has been in West Hartford for 24 years. It's a while. It's been a little while. He's a fantastic musician. He came to us from the Boston area. It's so wonderful to have such a fantastic middle school sender. I don't want to say feeder. Center. Mr. Gamgee, since I've come to the district, and especially since I've been at Hall, we work together, he's always welcoming to me and the high school kids. He's just a fantastic teacher and educator, and I'm so happy that he works on Starford and works at KP. So thank you, Joe, for being such a wonderful guy.
Thank you.
me think about all those years playing all those concerts back in the day.
Yeah.
wherever we want and do whatever we want.
Yeah, and how's that working out for us?
Not so good.
How many auditions have you been on?
6.
How many gigs have you booked?
None.
Me neither. I can't even get a seat at a session on a street corner.
Yeah, but something's gotta give. I mean, there's a reason why we came here. There's so much music, so much life, so much
food.
Oh, life, rhythm. Would you stop thinking about food?
Maybe if I had a po' boy.
All right, why don't we go check out that club over there? See if they have any food for you.
Really?
Someone's gotta get what they want.
Let's give it up for Max Harris.
We continue on.
on here at Club Perdido with Harlem Airshaft, the Duke Ellington Classic. It's going to feature Emma Waddell on clarinet, Sam Dunlap on the trumpet, and Eli Heinen once again on the trombone. Harlem Airshaft.
Summertime, I feel inside.
haven't got the heart to stand those memories when my heart is still with you. And oh, midnight blows into
when so cold.
Yeah.
give it up for the Hall High School Corollaires. It's so blessed to have them here at Hall and under the fantastic direction of Lori Chen. Let's give her a big round of applause. I'm no longer the character at a club. My name is James Antonucci. I'm the band director of bands here at Hall High School. It's my distinct pleasure to be in front of all these fantastic students this evening and be here with you. Thank you. I have a couple of technical things to talk about. First, let's talk about our guest tonight, Ms. Chanel Johns. Can we give Chanel a big round of applause? Yeah. I told Chanel at intermission, I said, you know, I'm going to talk about you. And she's like, then I'm going to go hide. Chanel is a wonderful, wonderful singer. She's a graduate of Greater Hartford Academy of the Arts. She's a Hartford native. And we are just so... Chanel, come out here. Chanel, come out here. Let's give her another round of applause. And she can sing. That's a real deal right there. So thank you to Chanel for coming up there. She sat in traffic 6 hours today to get up here to you because everybody went back to work after two blizzard days. And we're just so appreciative of her contributions. There's another guest here tonight who's an adult-looking person in the trumpet section. His name is Dr. John DeVersa. Let's give him a round of applause. Song, which is his composition. He is the director of jazz at the University of Miami. He's actually our guest tomorrow night, so he graciously agreed to hang out in the trumpet section tonight and help us out because the kids have three shows in a row, and that's a lot for their chops. And that's probably the nicest thing a guest has ever done in the last, I don't know, 5-10 years I've been around Hall. So he is just a humble, wonderful human being, and he wrote us a great chart, and you're about to hear it, and you're really going to enjoy it. So, Mr. John DeVersa, you'll see him tomorrow night. Let's give him one more round of applause. Wonderful guest would not be possible with the Ellen Jean Goldfarb Memorial Charitable Trust. Once again, all these wonderful opportunities that our students experience, whether it be commissions, guest artists, some of the actual set construction you see behind me. What do you think of this set? Is it pretty good? Fantastic job. Thank you, Greg, our TV. But without the Goldfarbs, we would not have Pops and Jazz. So we are just so thankful to Bob and Frankie, and I think we should give them a warm round of applause. So we will guest this evening, the King Philip Middle School Jazz Band. Let's give them a round of applause. Brennan, Salsa Einstein, Gary Cole. Such a pleasure. Thank you, Joe Gansey. Wonderful contribution this evening. And thank you, students. You guys sound fantastic. Keep practicing, keep playing. We can't wait to see you up here as high school students on the stage. So thank you for coming and playing this evening. Couple other people. I do a couple different people every night. I talked about Emma Drake, our co-producer. Let's give him a quick round of applause. I talked about Lori last Saturday, and I have to talk about two really, they're kind of in tandem. First, I'm going to talk a little bit about Tessa Grunwald. She's our choreographer, and she does all the blocking for the show. Let's give a big round of applause. Everybody loves you. I sent at least 3 emails a year during this time reminding Mr. Satoon that it'd be really wonderful if we had a dance class, and if we were going to do that, Tessa should be the person teaching it. She is such a valuable part of Pops and Jazz. She helps with the creative collaboration of the theme of the show. She helps with the costuming with Kathy Cuckins, who we'll talk about in a minute. And she's just an integral part of Pops and Jazz, and we love her, and we're so blessed to have her, and she does wonderful work with the jazz dancers and everybody on stage, so let's give her a warm welcome. And last but not least, the person who has been around Pops and Jazz and was here since 2006, 2007, somewhere in the mid-2000s, Kathy Cuckins, her costume designer. She's a P&J parent extraordinaire. She is so important. We give her a budget of $1, and we say, go for it. And she looks at me and says, okay, mister. And she does a fantastic job. She makes half the things. She finds them at various places. She gets them donated. She prepares them. She keeps the kids just up and running and is a huge mentor to all the cast, but especially the dancers and the coordinators, and they're so appreciative of Kathy, so let's get Kathy a big hand. It's going to feature this evening Eli Heinen on trombone, Mike Burrell on bari sax, and Mr. Diversa on a very interesting instrument called an EVI. I will talk and give we'll have a quiz later. The band reminded me that I neglected to say that Dan Gittleman is also soloing on this too. I'm sorry. Thank you, Dan. Sorry. Dan Gittleman.
Thank you. Beneath the moon and under the sun.
We all know this.
What are you feeling for lunch, man?
It's not a question of what I'm feeling, it's a question of what we can afford.
If that's the case, not much.
Wait a minute. Oh my God.
What is it?
It's a lottery ticket. A winning lottery ticket.
For how much?
96,000.
Damn.
$96,000.
Whoa.
96,000.
Somebody won.
Yo, if I won the lotto tomorrow, well I know I wouldn't bother going on a spending spree. I pick up this cool PD engine speed. Then maybe if you're lucky, you'll think credit with me. I'll be a businessman, not your dad, and his daddy. Donald Trump ain't mine. And it hasn't been cashed out yet. So we're millionaires.
Guys, I'm really sorry to break this to you, but you didn't win. You see, these numbers, they have to line up, and...
I'm going home. I can't do this anymore. We don't have any money. We can't make gigs. I can't eat the way I like. I'm going home.
I feel like such a failure. I mean, what am I gonna tell my parents?
What am I gonna tell my dog?
Your dog? Whatever. I'm gonna start looking for flights. This is the worst. Whose number is this?
I don't know. It's the New Orleans area code, though.
Hello? No, yeah, I remember. Oh, I'm definitely interested. Oh, yeah. Oh, I have someone in mind. Oh, I can yeah, they can definitely come with me. Tonight? Perfect. See you then. We're staying.
What?
We got a gig.
When? Where?
Tonight. It's in 2 hours. We gotta leave now.
We gotta go.
Let's go. Thanks.